Alright everyone, now we're just getting started in our first gameplay video of Tales of Toast. We've just received our early access key, and now our little wisp is, I think he's going to be our main guide along this journey. He states to us, "Oh, you're finally awake. Head down the path and explore the world in all you can do. Quests will be available once we launch early access." So let's, looks like you just kind of wake up in a little camp here. Looks like it's, you can point to click navigate. You can also navigate with the WASD keys. No music in the starting zone, so that's kind of interesting. But I'm sure though. As time goes on, this is still very, very early access. Mini map here. It looks pretty, very basic, very clean, simple. To access your skills, inventory, guild, etc., click on the icon on the bottom right corner. Looks like it's flashing the first toggle menu buttons. So we have inventory, stats, spells and abilities, quest log, trade skills, social. Character, but let's take a look at all the trees. So in melee we have power strike, instant cast. Looks like you're restricted by what type of weapon can perform it. Same here, we have the tendon slash. Its effect decreases movement speed. We have the skull crack, which reduces target strength and accuracy. Rive, which causes a target to bleed for 2% damage every second. We also have Shield Bash, which I am probably going to use, just because I love shields and being able to bash with them is always fun. So that adds just an added effect of Sundered Armor. Decreased damage reduction by 5%. Bloodlust increases strength by 50% and decreases damage reduction by 30%. Guard, status effects block, increased damage reduction, whirlwind, only capable using two-handed weapons. So you have to have a two-handed axe, mace, or sword, but that deals 21 damage to all targets around you. And then we have adrenaline rush, which lasts for 5 seconds, and it increases your movement speed by 5%. Okay, and then in the magic trees, we have the fireball, which is a burnt target for 1% damage every second. We also have Holy Bolt, which is a healing spell. Then we have Lightning Bolt. It deals damage. Purify, which removes debuffs. Ice Bolt, decreases movement speed. Regeneration, looks like that's causing 3% of maximum health every 3 seconds. Holy Barrier, absorbs 90 damage. Firestorm, burns target for 1% damage. Blizzard, that's a channeled spell, and it causes decreased movement speed. Frost Nova, also channeled, decreased movement speed. Sacred Ground, also channeled, and it heals the target for 20 health every 3 seconds. Thunderstorm, also channeled, deals 18 damage. And Meteor, which looks like it deals a whole heck of a lot of damage, and it also must be channeled. And you can see that each of the spells requires a certain level, as well as a certain amount of points in the tree. Like, for example, to learn Purify, you have to have level 3 Holy Bolt, as well as 5 points total in the magic tree. Let's take a look at our ranged category. The first skill you have, Hemorrhage. Causes bleeding damage. Snare, decreases movement speed. Poison Arrow, causes poisons 2% damage. Arrow Rain, it's a channeled ability, deals 4 damage every 1 second. Lava Arrow, reduces your armor. Dire Arrow, decreases healing gain. Corrupt Arrow, decreases magic resistance. Silencing Arrow, it prevents anybody from using abilities. Well, I think the first skill we're going to go into is going to be our Power Strike. We've spent our point. Okay, let's take a look at our quest log. It did say that there are no quests in the game yet, so that's probably going to be useless at this time. And it actually nothing comes up when I click it. Trade skills, we have alchemy, blacksmithing, carpentry, cooking, leatherworking, tailoring, botany, fishing, mining, shearing, skinning, and woodcutting. I presume that the gathering skills are going to give you the resources you need to perform the crafting skills. Looks like you have a few recipes to begin with, and also... they have different levels. Now the botany, fishing, mining, shearing, and skinning, they don't have any skills for creating anything in those, but there is an experience bar, so I presume the more you collect of each type of those skills, you will level it up to be able to gather more advanced resources. We'll take a look at the guild button. Currently not in a guild. Creating a guild requires one blank guild charter. So you have to find some kind of a charter. Looks like activity is the activity log for the guild, as well as a bank log. So there's more to be had there. Oh, we have some emotes. We can dance. Let's see. Oh yeah, he's dancing away. We can sit. Let's find a little bit more appeasing area here. Yeah, we'll sit on this hill overlooking everything. And I think we can just turn our guy around. There we go. Perfect. We can also laugh. Wave. There he goes. Clap. Blush. Oh, so bashful. Can click no or disagree. No, he doesn't like that. Let's see what else we have here. Yes! He agrees. We can cry. So sad. Let's point. Look over there! Cheer. We've done it! Oh, angry. Let's see what that looks like. Grumpy. Very confused. Can't really see what's going on with that one. He just looks like he's standing there. So happy. Seems to be pretty standard. Excited. What's he doing? Yeah, he's getting his little crew on. Then we have taunt. And insult. Doesn't seem very insulting. It looks like some of the emotes haven't been implemented yet, but it's still very cool to see. So we've looked at the guild, we've looked at emotes, and then we have the game menu, of course. Options. You have sound options, gameplay options. Always stay behind player, so that's camera movement. Lock the mini map, player nameplates, NPC, own nameplate, show system time. Time stands for chat, enable trading, etc. Visible Wisp, key bindings, rotation speed, left-handed mouse. Very basic settings. The Crumb Shop. And I think that these are. I think that all of the crumbs are free during the alpha phase, 100% free. So we can control click to see. Oh, alt click to view. So you can kind of give you a preview of what they are. Those are pretty cool. Okay, I think I'll save some of those for a different video. Looks like you'll be able to purchase different emotes later in the game. Looks like there are some pets that we'll be able to get. Oh, look at that guy. You need to buy more crumbs first. Can I buy crumbs? They say they're free. Zero. Successfully purchased one crumb. Oh, look at that. That's so cool. So this is going to be a free-to-play game with cosmetic items such as this little pet and other items that you'll be able to purchase with crumbs through that crumbs menu there. So there'll be plenty of costume items that you'll be able to purchase, pets that you'll be able to purchase, different emotions that you'll be able to buy as well. So that's pretty cool. We'll look way more into these later on. But that's your first look here. I'm not going to go too far into it here quite yet. We're just getting started, so.